The first demo that will be shown in this final event of the 5G Zorro project is the one covering the use case one scenario. So we're going to present the automated market for real-time resource allocation. The purpose of this demo is to show, highlight, and in a way demonstrating the one of the some of the most innovative and let's say interesting feature of the 5G Zorro platform. The focus of this demo is the marketplace and the way offers can be created from single offers for network services and a lot of other assets that will be shown later on, and composed offer, creating offer composed of offer created by other operators, the interactive creation of licensing and service level agreements, as well as the possibility to automatically discover resources and services available on the architecture and translating them from their technical description to TMF models in a way that they can be human readable and purchased whenever included in an offer. Also, offer created by operators can be obviously purchased by other operators, and all of these offers and orders are persisted on a DLT. So we have a distributed ledger technology, as Giacomo mentioned before, that in this case of the marketplace is the Corda DLT. Then, apart from the marketplace demonstration, we also have the governance with the onboarding of a new stakeholder that in our demo will work and will act as a service consumer. The zero-touch orchestration, upon acquiring the offer offered by another operator, the services purchased will be instantiated and the licensing and SLAs attached to them, to it, monitored. Last, the security and trust. Among the deployment of the service, we're gonna establish a secure communication channel between in a cross-domain end-to-end service deployment. So, as I was saying before, in this demo we have four actors that we're gonna call operator A, B, C, and operator E. In this case, operator E is acting as an automotive vertical that its scope is to join the 5G Zorro marketplace and then lease an end-to-end services end-to-end service in order to basically enable the update, the firmware update of 5G enabled machine and enabled car in order to let's say have the cars connected to an edge server and then pull the firmware updates from the server available in the core. So in this demo, operator A, B, and C works as a service provider. Operator A is offering a core, while operator B is offering edge resources. Operator C will inspect its own, from its portal, will inspect the offer available on the market, purchase offer from operator A, purchase the offer from operator B, and then create a composite offer that will then be purchased by the automotive vertical, so operator E. This demo for use case one has been demonstrated, tested, and validated against the 5G Zorro testbed. That is basically a testbed that span across two facilities, one here in Madrid, the 5Tonic testbed, and the other one in Barcelona. So basically, the whole marketplace is anchored on the Corda DLT, and this Corda DLT and all the other components of the test of the marketplace are span across a few testbed, and the operators are placed in different testbed. So in this case, operator A, B, and C take place in the 5G Barcelona testbed, while operator E, the automotive vertical, is in the 5Tonic testbed here in Madrid. The asset that operator A and operator B offer to the market are in the form of network services. So the network service for the core offered by operator A comprise a 5G core, a emulated radio access network, and a programmable VPN gateway. Then the operator E has a network service that offer as a product offering comprising edge resources, the firmware application that will enable the car to pull basically the firmware and update it. Then it's the time for the video demo. We are gonna show the demo step by step, basically describing one step and then proceeding with the video demo that describe and show how it is implemented and demonstrated. The first step is basically performed by operator A and operator B that make use of the 5G Zoro platform and the portal automatically discover the resources on the underlying architecture and then translating them, as I was saying before, in TMF models, so resource and service specification that then they can be used to create product offering that will be seen by the other operators of the 5G Zoro marketplace. Then, apart from the resources and services describing the network services, operator A and operator B will also upload on their local portal the templates for licenses, for licenses for operator B and SLAs for operator A. So let's see this first step of the demo. As I was saying, operator A will provide a product offer for the core that will comprise three VNF, the core, the VPN gateway, and the emulated radio access network. Here you can see the 5G Zoro portal, the technical resources and services are automatically discovered and they can be translated in the form of TMF service specification that, as I was saying before, they can be then used in order to create product offering. Here the characteristic of the resources are shown. After that, as I was saying, operator A proceed to uploading on the portal an SLA template, a service level agreement template, that then can be used to create a service level agreement object that can be attached to an offer in order to be monitored whenever instantiated. Here the template has been uploaded and shown in order to see the legal details. Operator B basically performed the same steps. It offered a network service in the form of a service specification, comprised three resource specification, so three VNF with their characteristic. So here we have the automatic translation from the technical description to TMF models, and then the final result with all the characteristics of the service in a human readable language. Then operator B proceed with the uploading of a license template that then will be attached to a product offering price that will be connected to a product offering in order to describe the licensing licensing terms related to an offer that will be then instantiated for operator E that will buy the whole composite offer that will be created by operator C. But before that, the product offerings need to be created, since for now we only created the service specification that described the network services that could be offered to the other stakeholders of the 5G Zoro platform. In this second step of the demo, we're gonna use for operator A and for operator B the service level agreement created, the license, the templates, the license, the license template created, and the service specification created to build a product offer. Oh, well, two product offers, one for operator A and one for operator B. Operator A will offer the core, while operator B will offer the edge resources. So, from the perspective of operator A, the first step is the creation of the SLA object that will be used for basically filling the template, creating the SLA object that will be then connected to a product offering. Product offering will be then persisted once created in the DLT, disseminated among the, all the other operators that can that can then visualize it on their local portal. So here the license is filled, the template is filled with the values inserted by the operator A. Then operator A has all the assets that he needs to create his own offer. So the offer for the core. In this tab of the portal, we can create a product offer. We select the service specification describing the core. We select the price associated to this offer. And we fill all the parameters connected to the offer, for the core offer. So the name, the location, in this case Barcelona, the description, the validity of the offer, and the category. In this case, as I was saying before, it is a product offer. Then the license created, the SLA created before, is attached to the offer. The submit button is pushed, and the offer is available on all the other operators. Operator B, it performs basically the same steps, but in this case we are gonna show also the creation of the price, because the license that has been uploaded on the portal and then filled with the actual values needs to be attached to the portal. So when the product offering will be included in operator in the offer built by operator C and then acquired by operator E, then we need to be monitored in order to basically respect the terms of the license. Then here the product offering is created for the edge offer, and then as well as the offer for the decor disseminated among all the other operators. Step three, the operator C exploit the portal to find and purchase the offer created by operator A and operator B. Then he purchases those offers and creates, using them, a brand new offer that basically represents the end-to-end service that will purchase the by operator E, the new stakeholder of the platform and the automotive stakeholder. Operator C, acting as a service provider, search the portal for the offer created, and maybe we can skip a bit, not this way. Okay. Basically, all the action performed by operator C are the same performed by operator A and operator B. Select the offers and creating the composite offer in the same way it was performed for operator A for the core and for operator B for the edge. Then it's the turn of operator E, the stakeholder. Operator E will join the marketplace, basically registering itself to the portal. So here the governance aspect of the 5G Zorro platform will be demonstrated. So operator E will join the platform, and using an intent-based search, we look on the catalog to an offer that respect its intent. So in this example, we are showing a human language's intent-based research which is used by the operator E to look in the catalog for a composite offer for Edge and Core in Barcelona in order to be then purchased, as we are seeing now, and then instantiated in a second step. Here, the composite offer created by operator C is purchased, filling all the fields for the creation on a new order. Then the order, as well as the offering, is disseminated on the DLT, but in this case only among the buyer, the seller, and the regulator. So in this case, operator C, operator A, and operator E, since operator A is also working as governance. In fact, when operator E registered to the platform, he was accepted by operator A. Then, instantiation. When the offer is end-to-end offer is acquired, is ordered by operator E, from the portal, operator E could ask the instantiation of the offer, so the end-to-end service. The ISSM will take care of instruct all the other ISSM that take place in all the other operators to instantiate the network service that comprise the composite offer. So the instantiation of the network service for the core in operator A and the instantiation of the edge in operator B. So here we can appreciate the workflows that basically instruct all the other ISSM, and the ISSM will instruct the NSSO to instantiate the network services. And then after that, the service will spawn and be deployed across the two facilities. And the firmware update edge app service available for the car manufacturer to instruct their automotive vehicle to use this service and firmware update the vehicle. In the meanwhile, that ISSM instructs the other ISSM for the instantiation, the NSSO will contact the licensing manager for the management of the license. So the network service for the edge app that has been instantiated also need to be monitored. The licensing manager will spawn a watcher that will basically see that all the terms specified in the license are respected. The last step of this demo is a demonstration of the functionalities of the Edge app. So here we can see basically all the placement of the components in the core and edge. In the in the bottom right of the screen, we can see the emulated vehicle, 5G vehicle that basically registered to the core server. Then you login and receive back from the server the IP address of the edge and a token that will use to retrieve the list of available firmwares on the edge, and then choose one among them and download. So it can basically update its firmware. So that's it, and thank you.